was there by faith, I receive my son.
One sixty in the Saints hymnal. Dwelling in Beulah Land.
Never shall run dry. by God's hand.
Here the sun is always shining.
Same book.
150.
Morning.
Christina, what was Rebecca singing on the way this morning?
Well, she was singing the same song that yeah. called out.
170.
170. Rebecca was singing from the top of her lungs. She was crying. And then you call.
Well, say that, yep. Say like me.
Out of the mouths of children sometimes yeah, comes you. The word of God.
I have Jesus.
I'm just thankful I'm being here. That's what I feel this morning. I'm thankful that I'm here this morning. And Amen. I'm sure each one of you are thankful to be here too.
Amen.
We have to give God reverence that He is the one we serve. Sister Liliana, Liliana. Which one did you have?
What number?
63
in the
Songs of
Zion.
Songs of Zion.
63.
This is
going to
be our last song. After this, we'll get started with our meeting.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, buenos días. Welcome to the Church of Jesus Christ. Bienvenidos a la Iglesia de Jesucristo. Ojalá que tuvieron una buena semana. I hope you had a good week. We come to here to give honor and glory to God. Aquí venimos a darle honor y gloria a Dios por todo lo que Él hace para nosotros. Como Él está protegiendo y nos está ayudando en todo lo que tenemos que hacer en nuestra vida. We come here to give Him glory for what He does for us each and every day and how He takes care of us during the week and how He helps us get through it. I believe, see, Sister Ida and Sister Benny are sitting at the table. What song have you all selected? 130, there's a river.
dear Lord, we thank you for that river, Lord, that flows from heaven, Lord, onto earth, Lord.
Amen.
That river, Lord, that allows us to be able to taste the blessings and the blessings that you have for us, Lord. To be able to take it in, to be able to absorb it, to be able to lift us up, Lord, in our time of need, Lord. To be able to just feel your spirit, Lord, fall upon us, Lord. When we take in that fountain, Lord, the water off that fountain, Lord, that just continues to lift us up time and time again, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your Son, Jesus Christ, Lord, who died for the sins of this world. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the sacrifice you made, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the times that you correct us, Lord, when we've done wrong. We thank you, Lord, for the times that you forgive us, Lord, when we come to you and we say we're sorry, Lord.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord, for the mercy and grace you bestow upon these people here in Fort Worth, Lord, and across the world, Lord, members of this church, Lord, that when they come to you, Lord, with an open heart and saying, I'm ready, Lord, please accept me as I am, and you take us as if we were your only child, Lord. You accept us, Lord, as we are, but you make us better once we're yours, Lord. You make us better, Lord. You mold us, Lord, into the person you want us to be.
Amen.
There's things that you pull out, Lord. There's things you pull out of us, Lord, that we shouldn't have. There's things you add to us, Lord, as you mold us, Lord. Things we never thought we could do. Things we never thought would be possible for us, Lord. But it's because of you, Lord, and for that I am thankful, Lord. We ask you, Lord, that you be here, Lord, with us today in this meeting, Lord. That you run this meeting, Lord, that you're the one speaking, you're the one bringing the message, Lord.
Amen.
That you're the one, Lord, that the people listen to, Lord. Because of you, Lord, we are better today. I've talked with members in the past, Lord, and I ask them, is your life better today with God in your heart, with Jesus Christ as your Savior? And every single one that said yes, 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 they recognize how you've changed them for the better, Lord. And I'm thankful for that. Be with us today, Lord. We ask you all this in your Son, Jesus Christ, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Brother Juan, as you started praying to God, the Spirit of God has come upon your words. I saw Christ coming and behind you with his arms all stretched out and listened to my people. My people.
La hermana tuvo una visión cuando comencé a dar oración para nuestro servicio. Dice la hermana que cuando estaba dando la oración, que miró que Jesucristo estaba atrás de mí con sus manos abiertas diciendo que esta es mi gente. Esta es mi gente. Before we get started, just want to talk to you about something that, some news that we got yesterday, some good news. As you know, a number of us have been going to visit Israel Zuniga, who was paralyzed. And when you go visit someone in the hospital and their loved one is laying there in the bed and can't move, you try to encourage them, try to let them know that it's going to be better, that it's going to be okay, that they're going to get through it. And we anoint and we pray and we give them encouragement, tell them to believe in God. And you go visit, and they're still there laying in the bed, not moving. And you anoint and you pray, and you tell them to believe in God. You tell them to have hope. And you go again, they don't move, and you do the same thing. Yesterday, Ida and I went to go visit, and when we walked into the room of Israel's room, his mom was there. His wife was not there at the time, his mom was. And I sort of felt a little bad, because here's the mom of this child, seeing him just sitting there, not moving. I walked in and greeted her, and what I also was sad about was she was in there alone. Her husband wasn't with her. And I walked in and she stood up and she smiled. Hadn't seen her smile since the last number of visits. And I asked how things are going. She said, he's opened up his eyes. He can lift his right arm. He can communicate with us by blinking his eyes. She says, it's getting better. It's getting better. He says, he can grip with his right hand. He says, we're getting there. And she said, thank you for your prayers. We need to have faith that it's possible. We need to have faith that it can happen. We need to keep praying for one another. Amen. Okay? You guys got up this morning. Some of you, the first thing you did was wash your face and wash your mouth and then went out and got the coffee pot ready. Some of you might have gone straight to the coffee pot. Some of you brushed your teeth and, you know, washed up and all that, and maybe opened a book of scripture and started reading it. Some of us woke up, shut off the alarm, and rolled over and slept some more. Hmm. Think about what you did this morning. Think about the first 10 minutes of your morning this morning. And think about the individual that's laying there and can't move. That could be one of us one day. Amen. That could be one of us. That can't get up, that can't speak, that can't open his eyes. That can't do anything for himself and that has to be taken care of. Are you going to believe that God can take care of you in your time of needs? Are you going to believe that he's going to be there for you when you need him? Are you going to trust in God in your worst time of your life to say he will pull you through? Amen. If you do, I thank you for thinking that way. If you're not sure, I tell you today, get on your knees and pray that you have that level of faith that you can say that. That you can say, God will take care of me. He will provide for me. And be able to say to your brothers and sisters, I prayed for you because I heard the need for you. I heard the need that you have. I heard the cry. I saw the text message. I prayed for you. We need to pray for each other in everything. Amen. Be mindful of that. Be mindful. We could be gone tomorrow. We all have plans. We all have things we want to do. We all have, many of us say, we want to be able to do better. We want to be able to have a better life. I want to be able to earn more money to be able to do this for my family. I want to be able to travel. I want to be able to do this. I want to be able to retire. There's nothing wrong with any of that. But what are you doing on your daily basis from a spiritual life? Are you living it the way you should live it? Are we living our life the way we should, day in and day out? Be mindful of those that have needs. When you hear the ministers up here say, pray for so-and-so, don't just let it go in one ear and out the other. Pray for them. When you see that text message come across, I hope you don't say, oh, there she goes again, sending something out. I hope you're saying, let me see what's going on. Be mindful of how blessed we are. Amen. We are a blessed people. God bless you. God bless you. I love you. I care about you. I love you, my brothers and sisters. I love the ministers who I serve. And I love God. But he's there for us each and every day. Don't ever forget that. Amen. Don't ever forget that. Amen. Let's sing one more song. 146. We're going to sing 146, Sing Glory, and then our brother Jeremy is going to open up a service.
Glory to God, and we sing. Glory. Good morning. Brother Juan, I felt such a beautiful spirit in your opening remarks, and you asked us a question: are we going to trust in God in our time of need?
Hermano Juan, tu oración, si te es una pregunta, si vamos a tener confianza en nuestro Dios en nuestro tiempo de necesidad.
And that's my message today, that God is with us.
Ese es mi mensaje este día, que Dios está con nosotros.
A few days ago, I had a dream where God gave me a message and put two songs on my heart that I heard during this dream.
Este, unos cuantos días pasados, tuve un sueño, y Dios me puso dos cantos en mi mente en este sueño.
And so now, I'm here to tell you about it.
So ahora estoy aquí para decirles esto.
And I'm excited to be here with each of you.
Y me encanta estar aquí con cada uno de ustedes.
I look out and I see all different stories. Those that I call my brothers and sisters, and our two young men here who are about to become our brothers.
Este, miro aquí en este punto de vista, miro mis hermanos y hermanas en Cristo, y también miro a dos que se van a bautizar aquí. Les puedo decir que van a ser mis hermanos.
And I'm very excited to see you as well.
Estoy encantado estar aquí y mirarlos aquí.
I'm excited to see that you're all here and that you're excited for the Lord.
Estoy encantado que ustedes están aquí para darle gloria a Dios.
And the things that he has in store for his people.
De las cosas que él tiene preparado para su gente.
And as we read the scriptures, we see that there is a pattern.
Cuando leemos la escritura, miramos que hay algo que sigue igual.
And what happens is God makes a promise and a prophecy.
Lo que pasa es que Dios hace una promesa y una profeta.
And he forewarns his people when major events are coming.
Y le avisa a su gente cuando algo mayor va a pasar en la vida de ellos.
Now that demonstrates the power of God, that he can prophesy the future.
Y eso es el poder de Dios, que él puede mirar lo que va a pasar en lo futuro.
But it also demonstrates his mercy to us, that he might be willing to warn us of what's coming.
Pero también eso es parte de la misericordia de Dios, que él nos puede avisar del mal lo que va a venir.
Because sometimes what's coming is punishment for the sins of mankind.
Porque muchas veces lo que viene, ese es el castigo por los pecados del hombre.
But in the midst of those prophecies warning us,
pero en esos tiempos cuando él nos da un mensaje que lo está avisando,
part of the message is to repent and be spared.
Parte del mensaje es que tenemos que arrepentir para que nos pueda ayudar a seguir adelante.
And part of the message is that God will protect his people.
Y parte del mensaje es que Dios va a proteger a su gente.
So I have first a couple of points to make that are related.
Primero tengo unos puntos que quiero platicar de esto que van con esto.
That we get warned and that we get promises.
Que nos avisa y también nos da una promesa.
Promises of help and protection.
Promesas de ayuda y que nos va a proteger.
So let me give you some examples of warnings.
Vamos a darles unos ejemplos donde él nos está avisando.
In the Old Testament, God mercifully told Israel, if you don't get it together, Babylon is coming.
Dios le dijo a la gente de Israel que si no lo hacen lo que deben hacer, si no se ponen de acuerdo en lo que él quiere de ellos, que Babylon va a venir y los va a llevar como esclavos.
And this was kind of the first event of its kind.
Y esta era la primera vez que pasó esto aquí.
And the Lord told the prophets that many more kingdoms would come after Babylon to conquer them if they were not obedient.
Y Dios le avisó a los profetas que van a haber otros reinos en el mundo, unos reyes de carne del mundo que los va a llevar como esclavos si no se arrepienten lo que han hecho y no siguen adelante con los mandamientos de Dios.
There was destruction coming.
Viene a destruir.
And we can compare that to today, because in this day and age we see much sin in the world, and because of that sin, destruction is coming.
Y podemos mirar eso también en el día de nosotros que estamos aquí, porque hay mucho pecado en este mundo, y cuando hay mucho pecado, muchas cosas se van a destruir.
You know, in the midst of Babylon, that's what started the Book of Mormon.
En el tiempo de Babilón es donde comenzó el libro de Mormón.
So in the midst of that destruction, something great happened where God sent people out to come to this land.
Y en ese ejemplo que nos está dando aquí es que Dios estaba destruyendo algo, pero también sacó a la gente de ahí que ellos venían a este país para estar aquí.
That they might be spared.
Que ellos puedan estar libres, están salvados aquí.
And so, Lehi and his family came here and they established themselves.
So entonces vino Lehi y la familia de él y se establecieron aquí, en este país.
And if you fast forward a few centuries, what happened here?
Y si te vas adelante unos cuantos, muchísimos años, ¿qué pasó aquí?
The same thing.
Lo mismo pasó aquí.
Destruction.
Destruir.
Because of sin.
Porque de pecado.
Now I could go on, but this pattern happens again and again in the scriptures.
Y así es el modo que siendo otra vez que uno hace pecado y lo van a destruir y pasa otra vez y otra vez y otra vez.
So God warns, then the destruction comes, but God also has mercy and delivers his people who are righteous.
Pero también otra vez diciendo que Dios avisa lo que va a pasar, va a destruir para quitar lo que es el mal y también otra vez les ayuda a la gente para que sigan adelante y todo va bien para ellos por un tiempo.
In Egypt, Moses is another example.
En Egipto, Moisés es otro ejemplo.
Now there was suffering.
Hay gente que estaban sufriendo.
Amongst the people of God.
Y eran la gente de Dios.
But God was going to deliver them.
Pero Dios los iba a salvar.
Before they were delivered, they had to confront their enemies.
Antes que Dios los vaya a ayudar, ellos tenían que dar adelante de sus enemigos.
And it started with Moses.
Y comenzó con Moisés.
And Moses said, "Please not me."
Y Moisés dijo, "Por favor, no escoges a mí."
He said, "Who am I that I might deliver your people?"
Y Moisés platicando con Dios dice, "¿Quién soy yo que puedo hacer libre a tu gente?"
It's a good question. Who are you?
Es una pregunta buena. ¿Quién eres usted?
And what might God want to do through you?
¿Y qué es lo que quiere Dios que usted hace para él?
So God reassures Moses before all of this happens, right?
Entonces Dios le avisa a Moisés que la va a ayudar en todo esto.
He comes to Moses in a burning bush.
Viene a Moisés en un forma de un fuego que está ahí delante de él.
Can you imagine hearing the voice of God and saying, "Be careful, you're on sacred ground," feeling the earth shake, and then the Lord God begins to speak to you.
Puedes ponerte ahí en ese punto donde está Moisés, que estás adelante ahí y miras este fuego que está ahí y oyes la voz de Dios que te dice, estás en una tierra santa. ¿Cómo te vas a sentir que se está temblando la tierra abajo de usted?
And then God gives Moses a rod.
Y después Dios le da a Moisés un palo.
A rod of power.
Un palo que él tiene, que tiene poder.
And with that rod, he does many things.
Y con ese puede hacer muchas cosas.
He casts the rod down and it becomes a serpent that the power of God might be demonstrated.
Lo pone en la tierra, lo baja ahí y se cambia de un palo a un serpiente que está enseñando a Dios el poder que él tiene.
And this was done the first time when it was just God and Moses.
Y esto pasó la primera vez nomás cuando era Dios y Moisés.
Simply for the purpose of Moses to understand, this is how I'm going to be with you.
Lo hizo Dios de esta manera para un ejemplo para Moisés, para demostrarle a Moisés que él tenía poder y que Dios iba a estar con él.
And then later on, he repeats the exercise in front of Pharaoh.
Y después lo hace otra vez Moisés con el poder de Dios delante del faraón.
And with Pharaoh, he causes many plagues, right?
Y con faraón pasan muchas cosas malas ahí que pasan.
And then with that rod again, he parts the sea.
Después con ese mismo palo aparte y abre el río Rojo.
See, now we're getting into, you know, God had shown him this power. He said, "I'll be with you." But now we're getting into the story where he confronts Egypt.
So entonces en esta parte Dios le ha enseñado a Moisés lo que puede ser y cómo lo va a usar. Pero ahora lo ponemos en esta parte de la historia donde Moisés se va a estar contra Egipto.
I don't know what kind of enemies you face on a normal day in your life.
No sé qué tipos de enemigos tiene usted en cada día de su vida.
On this day for Moses, it was the entire civilization of Egypt.
En este día para Moisés era toda la gente de Egipto que estaba contra él.
But God said he would be with Moses, and he would. He was.
Y dijo Dios que él iba a estar con Moisés para siempre, y sí estaba ahí.
Let us remember that the same God of Moses is our God today.
Vamos a ponernos a acuerdo que el mismo Dios de Moisés es el mismo Dios que tenemos nosotros.
In the desert, Moses took the rod and struck the rock and produced water out of a rock for people to drink.
En el desierto donde necesitaban agua, Moisés le tocó con este palo a la piedra y salió agua. Ellos podían beber agua.
And when they were afflicted with serpents biting them, he held up a rod with a serpent and said, "You'll be saved if you just look."
Y en otro punto donde el enemigo le estaba haciendo mal a la gente y los serpientes le estaban atacando y le mordieron, Moisés puso como algo de un mudo de un serpiente en el palo y lo levantó y dijo, "Si nomás miran aquí,
it's like us today.
Van a salir bien.
If we just look up to God, así, we can be saved too."
Así para nosotros, si nosotros nomás miramos para arriba, para Dios, Él nos va a ayudar.
And the story goes on with manna, with quail being produced for them to eat in the desert.
Y también cuando están en el desierto, parte del poder de Dios es cuando les trae el pan, la manna que cae de los cielos, y también le trae carne, porque estaban alegando que querían más, y les traigo la carne que cayó, que eran los pájaros.
And God said, "I'm going to protect you in front of you and behind you."
Y dice Dios, yo te voy a proteger adelante de usted y de atrás de usted.
And they saw the evidence of that when they saw the pillar of fire and the cloud following them everywhere they went.
Y miraron eso, la gente miraron eso que era real, porque miraron la nube que estaba sobre de ellos, que le da sombra, y también miraron el fuego que estaba atrás de ellos, que los estaba protegiendo.
And eventually the story of Exodus lands them before the city of Jericho, where the walls tumble down.
Hasta cuando ellos llegan a la ciudad de Jericho y que caen las paredes.
How many times did God show his people that he was with them?
¿Cuántas veces enseñó Dios a su gente que él estaba con ellos?
And you know, he's done the same for us.
Y ha hecho lo mismo para nosotros.
How many times has he answered our prayers and blessed us and delivered us?
¿Cuántas veces él nos ha contestado nuestras oraciones y nos ha bendecido y nos ha protegido?
Now that brings me to my third and final point.
Y me trae al tercer y último punto que quiero hacer.
That we have to remember what God can do.
Que nosotros nos tenemos que recordar lo que puede ser Dios.
Remember that God said he will be with his people.
Acuérdate que Dios dijo que él va a estar con su gente.
The only question that should be in your mind is, am I his people?
La única pregunta que debes tener en tu mente es, ¿soy la gente de él?
If you are his people, you need not fear.
Si tú eres la gente de Dios, no debes tener miedo.
Our brothers to be are about to take upon them the name of Jesus Christ.
Los hermanos que se van a bautizar aquí en el próximo domingo, ellos van a recibir el nombre de Jesucristo sobre ellos.
That's how you become his people.
Así es como se hace uno la gente de Dios.
I'm going to read some scripture. This is in the beginning of the Book of Mormon, in the Book of Nephi. 1 Nephi 17, verse 40.
Este va a ser en primer Nefi, libro de Mormón, primer Nefi, capítulo 17, versículo 40.
And it says, "And he loveth those who will have him to be their God."
Y aquí nos dice, él ama a los que lo aceptan por Dios.
All you have to do is choose God and he will love you.
Todo lo que tienes que hacer es escoger a Dios, aceptarlo y él te va a amar.
Says, "Behold, he loved our fathers and he covenanted with them."
Y dice, él amó a nuestros padres, hizo alianzar con ellos.
You see, this is the way God works. When you love him and show it, he makes a promise to you.
Así lo hace Dios, él hace una promesa y él nos enseña.
Yea, even Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, he did this with, and he remembered the covenants which he had made.
Y aquí nos dice con Abraham, Isaac y Jacob, y recordó las alianzas que ha hecho y los sacó del país de Egipto.
So, if you remember that God will be with us.
So si usted se acuerda que Dios va a estar con nosotros.
God will remember his covenant with you.
Dios se va a acordar de la promesa que él hizo con usted.
And he says, wherefore he did bring them out of the land of Egypt.
Y nos dice aquí cuando los sacó del la país de Egipto.
I hope that you're catching that in this verse. It is saying that the same promises he made to those who he delivered out of Egypt, he's offering to you here and now today.
Ojalá que pongas a cuadro que el mismo Dios que los sacó de Egipto, le hizo la promesa que los voy a sacar de ahí, es el mismo Dios que tenemos aquí para nosotros.
And that makes sense because God doesn't change.
Y eso nos pone a cuadro que es así porque Dios no cambia.
Over time, he is the same God yesterday, today, and forever.
Por el tiempo, nos enseña que él es lo mismo de antes, de hoy y para siempre.
I'm going to turn over a bit in the Book of Mormon to Mosiah, first chapter.
Vamos a ir otra vez en el libro Mormón, vamos a estar en el libro de Mosiah.
Starting in the fifth verse.
Comenzando con versículo 5.
I say unto you, my sons, were it not for these things which have been kept and preserved by the hand of God, that we might read and understand his mysteries, and have his commandments always before our eyes, that even our fathers would have dwindled in unbelief.
En comenzando con el versículo 5, os digo, hijos míos, que de no haber sido por estas cosas que se ha guardado y conservado por la mano de Dios para que nuestros perdimados leer y entender sus misterios y siempre tener sus mantenimientos ante nosotros ojos, aun nuestros padres habían caído en la incredulidad.
I'm going to pause there halfway through and just read that first half of the verse. But what it's saying is if our fathers, those spiritual men who went before us and women who, if they had not had the word continually before their eyes, they would have dwindled in unbelief.
Y aquí nos está diciendo que si nuestros padres, nuestros abuelos, la gente que vivía antes de nosotros, que son nuestras familias, si ellos no tenían la palabra de Dios adelante los ojos de ellos, ellos podían caer en las cosas mal de este mundo.
Now's the part where I try to bring this into your life and make it relevant.
Y este punto lo pongo, les leo lo siguiente para que entiendan el punto que quiero saber aquí para que sea real para ustedes.
My message today is, remember, God will be with us.
Mi mensaje hoy es que acuérdese, Dios está con nosotros.
Easier said than done.
Es simple para decirlo de que hacerlo.
So how do we remember?
So ¿cómo los recordamos de nuestro Dios?
I'll come back to that in just a moment, but let me just say that even though you may not feel like you are a Moses fighting a war with Egypt,
puede ser que no te sientes que tú eres un Moisés que está peleando con Egipto.
For one, we have a similar prophecy today that came forth in the days of Babylon. We know that we're living in latter days and destruction and judgment is what we anticipate.
Sabemos que vivimos en un tiempo como eran para ellos, en un tiempo que va a venir un tiempo que nosotros vamos a tener que vivir por el día que llega que nos vamos a poner delante de Dios y él va a ser nuestro juez entre todo lo que nosotros hemos hecho.
So that part applies to you.
Eso esa parte aplica a nosotros.
But I would actually add that the battle has already begun.
Pero les digo que la pelea ya comenzó.
Spiritually speaking, we're already in the midst of extreme warfare.
Espiritualmente, ya estamos en la pelea de lo que está pasando.
I feel it every week.
Yo lo siento cada semana.
I feel it every day.
Yo lo siento cada día.
I feel that dream that was given to the church about the enemy as a wolf coming directly at us. I feel that.
Yo me acuerdo del sueño que la iglesia recibió del lobo que viene a atacar a la gente de Dios. Lo siento.
Do you feel it?
¿Lo siente usted?
I feel it physically.
Yo lo siento físicamente.
I feel it spiritually.
Lo siento espiritualmente.
I feel it relationally.
Lo siento de relación.
I feel it emotionally.
Lo siento de emoción.
That every day I get out of bed, the enemy is right there trying to knock me off the path.
De cada día que me levanto de la cama, está el enemigo que me quiere trompecer.
We're already in the battle, brothers and sisters.
Ya estamos en la pelea, hermanos y hermanas.
In the sixth verse, it says, "Oh, my sons, I would that ye should remember that these sayings are true, and also that these records are true. And behold, the plates of Nephi, which contain the records and sayings of our fathers from the time they left Jerusalem until now, they are true. And we can know of a surety because we have them before our eyes."
Versículo 6 dice lo siguiente. Oh, hijos míos, quisiera que recordás que estas palabras son verdaderas y también que estos anales son verdaderos. Y he aquí también las planchas de Nefi que contienen los anales y las palabras de nuestro padre desde el tiempo de que salieron de Jerusalén hasta ahora son verdaderas y podemos saber de su podemos saber de su certeza porque los tenemos ante nuestros ojos.
So one answer as to how you can remember is to keep God's word in your heart.
Una manera de que los podemos recordar de todo esto es de tener los mandamientos de Dios en nuestro corazón.
Notice I'm not saying just read the word. Keep the word in your heart.
No, nomás les digo que lean la palabra. Deja que tengas la palabra en tu corazón.
The other goal I have for you, the other helpful hint.
La otra meta que tengo para ustedes y que les digo lo siguiente.
Is that you keep the songs, the hymns.
Que tengas los cantos.
Upon your hearts and upon your lips.
En tu corazón y en tus labios.
You know, it's overwhelming to read the scriptures sometimes.
Es muy increíble para leer las escrituras a veces como nos toca nuestro corazón.
But God has given us the messages of the scriptures in these beautiful songs.
Pero también Dios nos ha dado el mensaje de su escritura en estos cantos.
He's boiled them down into a few short, powerful verses.
Dios ha puesto su mensaje en estos cantos que es más nomás unas pocas palabras y nosotros podemos entender el mensaje que nos trae.
And through the power of music and rhyming, it's easier to remember.
Y por el poder de canto y de música, podemos recobrar de las bendiciones que Él tiene preparado para nosotros en estos mensajes.
The Lord literally says in the songs of Zion that these songs are manna for you.
Dios nos dice en los cantos, que estos cantos son como comida para nosotros, como la maná que cayó de los cielos santos.
And so, through the hymns that we sing and through the word of God, we can feed ourselves in the desert. And what I'm telling you today is you're already in the desert.
Y que le estoy diciendo que con estos cantos podemos recibir alimentos y como los que recibieron nuestros la gente que también lo siente en ese tiempo, pero la verdad es nosotros también estamos en el desierto hoy este día.
Because your faith is being challenged every day.
Porque tu fe es como que te están siendo que hagas una prueba de dónde estás en eso.
In the seventh verse it says, "And now my sons, I would that you should remember to search them diligently." Search the scriptures, search the songs, search the messages.
Y ahora en el versículo 7 dice lo siguiente. Y ahora, hijos míos, quisiera que os acordáis de escrituras diligentemente, que nos estudiamos y nos acordamos de eso.
That ye may profit thereby.
Para que esto os bendifique.
And I would that ye should keep the commandments of God.
Y quisiera que guardaréis los mandamientos de Dios.
That you may prosper in the land according to the promises which God made to our fathers.
Para que prosperes en el país de acuerdo con las promesas que el Señor a vuestros padres.
So as I was dreaming and this message was coming to me,
cuando tuve el sueño, me vino este mensaje.
In my mind, I was humming the hymn. It's in the Saints Hymnal, number 238.
En mi mente, oí el canto 238 que está en el libro de los que tenemos aquí de los cantos.
It says, lest I forget.
Y el canto decía que si no me olvido.
Gethsemane. Lest I forget, in other words, what Jesus did when he died.
Que si no los que no los olvidamos lo que hizo Jesucristo para nosotros.
Can you think of a more gripping picture to hold on to?
Puedes mirar otro algo más mejor que te puedes detener en eso, algo que esto.
When you're being fought against and feeling weak, bring your mind to the hill and the cross.
Que cuando,
upon which Jesus died.
Que cuando tienes una pelea que estás peleando, que llevas todo a la, al monte donde Jesucristo murió.
And you know, he didn't just die for you.
Él no nomás murió para nosotros.
Sometimes we struggle with making that relevant because, you know, you think, well, that happened 2,000 years ago.
Hay veces que podemos pensar que no es en realidad así porque eso pasó como unos 2,000 años pasados.
But make no mistake, he died for you today, that you might benefit today.
Acuérdate que Jesucristo murió para que usted pueda recibir una bendición de eso.
And he also continues to bless you after that.
Y él sigue dándole a ustedes una bendición para siempre.
So the Lord didn't just die for us, he blesses us over and over, every day of our lives.
Dios no nomás murió para nosotros, Él nos está dando bendiciones cada día.
And if picturing the sacrifice that Jesus made doesn't get you motivated, I don't know what will.
Y si miras este, el sacrificio que hizo Jesucristo para nosotros y no te puede ser que quieres aceptar eso y a seguir adelante, no sé qué más.
And when you respond to his sacrifice by wanting to serve him and obey him, he just blesses you all the more.
Y cuando quieres este, responder al sacrificio que hizo Jesucristo para nosotros, quieres a seguir a los mandamientos de él y hacer lo que él quiere que te está diciendo que hagas, él los va a bendecir más y más.
The hymn says, lest I forget thy thorn-crowned brow, lead me to Calvary.
El canto dice que si no se me olvida de la corona que él tuvo que tenía las espinas sobre la cabeza como una corona.
You know,
no se me olvida eso.
You might sing these old hymns and think, these melodies, this music, it's so old-fashioned, it's not today, it's not hip.
Puedes este, cantar estos cantos que son unos cantos muy viejos y puedes pensar estos cantos tan buenos, pero este, no son los cantos de hoy.
Okay, maybe the music doesn't grab you.
Puede ser que la música no te encanta.
Let the message grab you.
Deja que el mensaje que tiene el canto te agarre.
Because what it's saying is, if you're having a bad day and you're thinking to complain a little bit about it and say, Lord, I don't really feel like serving you today because my life is kind of falling apart.
Puede ser que tienes un día que todo está mal para usted y le dices a Dios, se me está fallando el día, hoy no quiero ser su servio.
What we should be saying is, oh Lord, remind me of that thorn brow, that crown that you wore. Lead my mind to Calvary that I might picture what you did for me on that day.
Entonces lo que debemos decir esto es que decir, acuérdame del tiempo de sacrificio que hizo usted Dios cuando usted tenía esa corona con esas espinillas ahí sobre su cráneo. Acuérdame de eso que me puedo acordar del tiempo que usted estaba en el monte crucificado.
That I might take my troubles and lay them beside what you did for me on that day and remember that these troubles I face are nothing.
Y de acordarme que los problemas que tengo se los pongo ahí a usted para un lado. Y que los problemas que yo tengo no son nada como los que usted tuvo.
Because he didn't just die for us.
Porque no nomás murió para nosotros.
He set us free.
Nos puso libre, nos hizo libre.
So what he did for us is more significant than in anything that we could go through.
So lo que hizo Jesucristo para nosotros es más increíble de algo que nosotros pudimos hacer.
And as I was dreaming, I saw myself at the piano getting ready to play a song, and the Saints Hymnal came before my mind again, and I opened to 71 in my dream.
Y en el sueño que tenía, Mire que me ponía delante del piano y iba a tocar un canto. El canto es número 70 en el libro de los Saints Hymnos aquí.
It says, children of Zion, awake from your sadness.
Is it 70 or 71?
71. Es el canto 71 que dice...
Dice, hijos de Sion, despiértate de la tristeza que tienes.
It says, strong are your foes, but his arm will subdue them.
Fuertes son tus enemigos, pero el brazo de Dios te va a detener.
And scatter their armies to regions afar.
Y que va a poner los enemigos, la gente de Dios, para unos países muy, muy, muy lejos de ti.
They'll flee like the chaff from the scourge that pursues them.
Ellos se van a ir y se van a desparmar como unas semillas que caen de la planta.
Are you picturing this? That the enemies you have are fleeing for their lives because God is pursuing them.
Puedes mirar este punto de vista que Dios está diciendo a los amigos que se van, enemigos que se van de ahí porque Dios lo está haciendo que se van a quitar de ahí de su presencia.
It says, for vain is their strength and their chariots of war.
Porque lo que ellos tienen no va a poder hacer nada contra nosotros porque nosotros tenemos nuestro Dios.
You think about the news sometimes.
Acuérdate, miras las noticias en veces.
Do you worry about nuclear warfare?
¿Piensas de las guerras que va a pasar?
It's all vain.
Eso es nada.
God's power.
Eso es nada si lo vas a poner contra el poder de Dios.
Lastly, it says, children of Zion, his power will save you.
Y también al punto de dice, la gente de Sion, el poder de Dios te va a salvar.
Oh, loudly extol it, o'er land and o'er sea.
Dígalo muy, muy alto sobre la tierra y la agua.
Shout, for the foe will be destroyed that enslaved you.
Grita, porque el enemigo que te está haciendo daño lo van a destruir.
The oppressor will vanish and Zion be free.
El que es el enemigo se va a poner para un lado y Sion va a estar libre.
I woke and I thought, I've never heard that song.
Desperté y pensé, nunca oí ese canto.
What a powerful message for us today.
Es un mensaje con mucho poder.
That we might be reminded of the God we serve.
Que nosotros podemos recobrar el Dios que nosotros somos el siervo de él.
The God for whom Egypt was no big deal.
El Dios que Egipto no era nada grande para él.
We need to keep these with us that we might survive the journey we're in, brothers and sisters and friends.
Tenemos que tener estos cantos con nosotros que nos pueda apoyar y ayudarlos para seguir adelante.
Let me just wrap up here. The Lord has given us sufficient warning.
Dios nos ha dado muchos mensajes para avisarlos.
Has he not?
¿Que no?
Hasn't he told us over and over again, get ready, make yourselves right.
Nos ha dicho Dios que nos tenemos que preparar, que los preparamos, nos ponemos listos para él.
And he's been merciful, I think, to stretch out the time.
Y él tiene mucha misericordia para darlos más tiempo.
You know, maybe if he had caused it to unfold sooner, more of us would have not been ready because we're procrastinating.
Y puede ser que muchas de estas cosas puedan pasar un tiempo más rápido, y en ese punto nosotros hay unos de nosotros que pudimos perder la oportunidad de seguir adelante porque no aceptamos a nuestro Dios o su Hijo.
Show forth your faith today by stepping out on the waters and obeying the Lord.
Enseña tu fe hoy para levantarte y entrar a las aguas de bautismo.
We know what's coming.
Nosotros sabemos lo que viene.
We know that God has promised to take care of us.
Nosotros sabemos que Dios le hizo la promesa para cuidarlos.
And we know that we need not fear if we are among the more righteous.
Y sabemos que no tenemos que tener miedo si nosotros estamos cuentos con los que están justos.
Search the word diligently.
Busca la palabra.
Sing the songs of Zion.
Canta los cantos de Sion.
Sing all the hymns.
Canta todos los cantos.
And keep the word.
Y sigue con la palabra.
That you might remember what God has said.
Que tú te puedas recordar lo que dijo Dios.
I love you, brothers and sisters.
Los amo, hermanos y hermanas.
This week, I felt so filled with the love of God.
Esta semana me sentí lleno con el amor de Dios.
That nothing else seemed to matter.
Que nada más me estaba molestando.
You know, my troubles seemed to melt away because I was just strengthened by the love and the charity that God offers.
Los problemas que yo tenía se me fueron por un lado porque estaba lleno con el Espíritu de Dios con lo que él me estaba avisando.
Make that your focus.
Hazlo lo que ese es tu punto de vista.
And you will be blessed.
Y vas a recibir una bendición.
Others.
Sure.
I'm going to take a chance. I'm going to gamble right now.
Not in church.
Not in church. Okay. Now, I want to ask you all a question, and I'm going to be a little bit sexist here. I'm going to direct my comments mostly to the sisters, or the women.
You're on your own.
There goes Brother Ken. He's already dead.
O ser una pregunta, y va a ser que es algo aquí que voy a preguntar a las hermanas. Esta es una pregunta para las hermanas. Disculpen que hago esta pregunta.
All
y esta pregunta viene del hermano Jerry, no del hermano Juan.
Sí. All the women who love to cook, stand up.
Todas las gentes, las mujeres que le gustan a cocinar, levántase.
Okay. Okay. Now, I want you to think in your mind right now, what is your favorite recipe to cook?
Quiero que pienses en tu mente ahorita, ¿qué es la receta que te encanta más de cocinar?
Okay, are you thinking about it?
Carne guisada.
Okay. No, don't plant any thoughts.
Brownies.
Okay, now, can you make this recipe from memory?
¿Puedes hacer esta receta de memoria?
Sí, 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 okay. What is your favorite recipe?
A barbacoa.
Barbacoa. What's your favorite recipe?
Su favorito receta.
Taquitos al pastor. Your favorite? Pasta. Okay, so, and I know if I went around, I could ask everyone. You could make it from memory. Why can you make it from memory?
¿Por qué puedes hacer esta receta de memoria? Because she likes it.
How many times have you made it?
¿Cuántas veces las has hecho?
Uno. Dos. Más y más. ¿Sí? We understand how to cook these recipes because we've done it over and over and over, and we like them.
Sabemos cómo hacer estas comidas que estamos platicando estas recetas porque las hacemos muchas veces y nos encantan y nos gustan la comida.
Is that true?
¿Serio?
Okay. Muchas gracias. Thank you. Sit down. That is how we should think about the Word of God.
Así debemos pensar también de la palabra de Dios.
We should have stories from the scriptures that we love so much that we can rehearse them from memory.
Debemos tener historias de las escrituras que nos encantan mucho que los podemos explicar y decir a otros de memoria.
Because we love those stories so much, we read those same stories over and over again.
Porque nos encantan esas historias que estamos leyendo de la escritura y los queremos leer otra muchas veces. Yes.
And that way, when someone comes to you and they're hungry, when your husband or your children, you think in your mind, I'm going to cook this.
Y cuando su marido o los niños vienen y le piden que tienen hambre, ustedes piensan o cocinar lo siguiente.
The same way when someone comes to you with a problem or you have a problem yourself.
La misma manera si alguien viene a usted con un problema o usted tiene un problema.
And you remember a story or a verse from scripture that you've read and you say, this is the answer.
O te recuerdas en ese punto la historia que has leído, leyete una historia y te acuerdas de eso y dices, esto es lo que voy a hacer.
Brother Jeremy said to us today that God draws near to those that have chosen him to be their God.
El hermano Jeremy dijo que Dios se va a acercar a la gente que se aceptan a nuestro Dios, que sea la gente de él.
The way we draw near to God is to love him, to read his word, and to completely immerse ourselves in God.
La manera que nos acercamos a Dios es que hacemos lo que él quiere que hacemos y estudiamos y enseñamos amor para cada uno y en realidadmente los ponemos con él.
We should read the word of God like we read some of our recipes.
Leemos leer la palabra de Dios como leemos las recetas que tenemos.
Because then they become a part of us.
Porque entonces se hacen parte de nosotros.
How many of you pass your recipes down to your children and grandchildren?
¿Cuántos de ustedes pasan las recetas a sus niños y sus nietos?
I remember For those of us that are older, it was more popular to write the recipes down and then hand them off to your children and grandchildren.
Me acuerdo cuando estaba joven, la costumbre era que escribías la receta en una carta y se los días a los niños y tus nietos.
Wouldn't it be nice to write down your favorite Bible verse or Book of Mormon verse and pass that on to your children and grandchildren?
Qué increíble puede ser que vas a escribir el versículo en la Biblia o el libro mormón que te encanta mucho y lo escribes en la carta y se los das a tus hijos o a tus nietos.
Wouldn't it be nice to hand them a little 3x5 card with that verse on it, say, this verse has gotten me through a lot of difficult times.
Qué lindo puede ser que le das esa carta con esa escritura que le estás dando y se los das a los niños y dices, esta es la escritura que me ayudó en el tiempo que yo tenía problemas.
So that when you're having problems, you remember that verse.
Para que cuando tú tienes problemas, tú te recuerdas de ese versículo.
Just like we sing these songs in church.
Así como cantamos estos cantos en la iglesia.
It would be hard in this branch for anybody here not to have a few of these songs memorized already.
Es puede ser muy difícil que va a ser miembros aquí que no pueden tener estos cantos en memoria, ¿ya? ¿Que no?
I would think that if you've been coming here any length of time, the way we like to sing, you should have a couple songs memorized.
Pienso yo con el tiempo que has venido aquí, no le hace si es un poco mucho, que ahí tienes unos cantos que te gustan a ti y te gustan cantar, ¿que no?
Those are God's gift to the church and to you.
Y esos cantos que tienes de memoria en tu mente, esos son los cantos que Dios nos ha dado como un don para nosotros.
Just like Brother Jeremy said, these are tools that God has given us to strengthen us in these latter days.
Estas son las herramientas que nosotros vamos a usar para ayudarlos para seguir adelante en estos días.
So that we can draw closer to God.
Para que nosotros podamos acercar más a Dios.
The reason we need to get closer to God is like Brother Jeremy said, we know the time is short.
La razón que los tenemos que acercar a Dios es porque sabemos que el tiempo es corto.
This world is falling apart all around us.
Este mundo se está cayendo sobre todo nosotros. Se está fallando este mundo.
It doesn't surprise me that the Lord reminded Brother Jeremy to remind us not to forget what Jesus Christ has done.
No es una sorpresa para mí que Dios le recordó al hermano Jeremy que nos tiene que decir de la promesa que hizo Dios para nosotros.
God is looking for a people that will love and serve him.
Dios está buscando una gente que lo van a amar y que lo van a servir.
A people he can lead to Zion.
Una gente que Dios puede llevar a la ciudad de Sion.
A people he can welcome into heaven.
Una gente que Dios puede invitar y recibirlos en los cielos santos.
Draw closer to the Lord because he's already with you.
Cércate más a Dios porque él ya está con usted.
God is closer than you think.
Dios está más cerca de lo que crees.
If you invite him, he'll come inside you.
Si lo invitas, él entra en usted.
If you invite him, he'll be inside your mind.
Si lo invitas, él va a estar en tu mente.
A loving God with his Holy Spirit directing your life.
Un Dios de amor que con su espíritu te está diciendo qué camino vas a tomar.
So that when you have problems or when you have questions, he's right there to direct your path.
Que cuando tú tienes problemas o tienes preguntas, él está ahí para ser su guía en todo.
Sound too good to be true?
Se siente que no es verdad, que no se puede pasar así.
What's this guy talking about?
¿Qué dice este hermano?
If you don't believe me, ask the people around you and ask them if they have that same experience.
Si no me crees, pregúntale a los hermanos y hermanas aquí y pregúntale si ellos han tenido esa experiencia.
If you have any doubts in your mind, ask God.
Si tienes duda en tu mente, pregúntale a Dios.
Any questions about him, he wants to answer those questions because he wants you to know him and to love him just like he loves you.
Cualquier pregunta que tienes, llévaselo a Dios porque él quiere que tú amas a él como él te ama a usted.
God is indeed with us.
Dios en realmente está con nosotros.
Now are you with him?
Ahora estás tú con él.
May God bless you.
Que Dios los bendiga. We're going to bring our meeting to a close. Next Sunday, we meet at the lake. We're going to have a couple of baptisms, Juan and Simon. And what time do we meet there? Ruben wants to be there early. We need to be there at 9:45 for this baptism, okay? All right, and then we'll come back here and continue with the next part of that. A couple of prayer requests. One of my coworkers that I used to work with, Amber Pearson, she's going through some difficulty with a company that she's with. It's a company I left in December, and they're having some major problems. She's looking for a job. There's some things that are being done that's unethical, but if you could keep Amber Pearson in prayer. One of my other coworkers, John Bentley, his wife is suffering from a severe case of COPD where she can't breathe. Long story short, it's the way John puts it, it's only a matter of some time before she'll pass away. She was supposed to have a lung transplant 2 years ago and she didn't move forward with it. And now she's too frail to be able to survive a surgery, among other things that she's dealing with. So keep John and Debbie Bentley in prayer. I received a text from Adam, one of the contractors I work with, that his son, we sent the text last week about one of the doctors that thought that the one-year-old had cirrhosis of the liver and thought he had cancer. Of course, his mom was devastated by this news, but they went and did more tests, and he thanked me for the prayers on y'all's behalf. Thank you for those. He says that it's not cancer, but they're gonna do some more tests, but his wife is very, very pleased that that's not the news. But continue to keep them in prayer, okay? Any other prayer requests? Yes?
My niece and nephew, her husband, I told y'all 3 years ago, they got 35 years for marijuana. He's getting out Tuesday. He was affiliated with the motorcycle club. They may try to force him back in. He has been born again. I know that happens a lot when they're in prison, but he said that God told him he would make the road. But my niece did not. She's flipping out. And y'all just keep him in prayer because it's going to look bad on him that he's getting out and she's not. Because they were all involved in that shooting that happened in Waco. And it's just a real bad situation.
Okay. Keep him in prayer. Hermana? Pidiendo oración?
Yo?
Our sister wants us to keep her son Victor in prayer. Victor and his girlfriend have moved into a location else where she wants us to keep him in prayer. Let's see another hand. Brother Richard?
My oldest son is stationed in South Korea, 10 miles from the DMZ. And it is heating up. They
are high alert. Okay. We'll keep him in prayer. La hermana Richard está pidiendo que ponemos su hijo en oración. Él está con el servicio de Estados Unidos y está allá en Corea. Donde se está poniendo las cosas muy peor, por favor ponga su hijo en oración. Brother Polly. Brother Polly was saying that we must make sure we keep Sister Margaret in prayer. Nothing really serious or anything, just that she misses not being able to be here with us on Sundays. Keep her in prayer. Okay? All right. Dígame, hermana.
Por mi papá.
¿Por su papá?
Sí.
Está bien. Le ponemos en oración. Our sister Concha wants us to keep her dad in prayer. As you know, she lost her mom. Keep them in prayer, please. Hermana. Para su hijo?
Sí, para mí.
¿Cómo se llama su hijo?
Alejandro
Martínez. Sister Emma from Mexico is asking us we keep her son in prayer. He's going through the process of getting his citizenship, and they've been delaying it, and she just doesn't understand what's going on. So again, keep her son Alejandro in prayer. Okay? Let's stand, and we're going to go ahead and close in prayer. Okay? Let's close in prayer, and again, continue to pray for those that are dealing with different things in their lives, okay? You've heard some of the testimonies today about how God is taking care of our people and how God provides for us. Continue to pray for those that have needs, all right? And I'm going to ask our Brother Tony, if you would you come up here and close us in prayer, please?
Let's turn to the Lord. Father in heaven, we're so thankful for this wonderful day, Father, and continue to be with us, Father. As our brother mentioned, Father, that we want to continue, Father, to draw closer unto you and continue to work in our lives, Heavenly Father. The children were blessed today, Heavenly Father. They got prayed on, Heavenly Father, and there's many that need prayer, Father. I pray, Heavenly Father, would you please watch over your children, the young children, Heavenly Father, as they're going to school, Father, and even ourselves, Heavenly Father, that you watch over us, Father, as we go to work, whatever we go, whoever we encounter, whoever we talk to, that we may give our testimony, Father, that your place, your hands, your protection over us, Father, wherever we go, we take you with us. Father, we can't turn to nobody, only to you, because you're our only Savior and you're our friend, a friend that we can trust and say that we love you. We know, Father, that blessed assurance that you will continue, Father, to love us, Father, and to love you. Keep us on that straight and narrow path, and our two pretty soon to be brothers, Father, that you watch over them this course of the week, Father, and many that you're calling, that they will listen and heed to your word, Father. I pray, be with us now. Remember those who are sick and afflicted. We ask you in these favors and blessings, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.